Namaste, dear children. How are you all? Fine. Very good. Let us start our math class, okay? Today, I am going to teach you algebraic expressions. What are algebraic expressions and why do we need algebraic expressions? Let us take some real life example to get an idea about algebraic expressions, okay? You have some chocolates with you and your little brother has two chocolates less than yours. How would we express this mathematically? We don't know the number of exact number of chocolates with you. Okay? Then how can we express? We want to know the number of chocolates with you, isn't it? Then only we can say. For that, let us assume the number of chocolates with you as x. Okay? Let it be x. Now you can easily tell the number of chocolate with your brother has, isn't it? Tell me, how many chocolates with your brother? Yes, he has x minus 2 chocolates. Okay, this is nothing but algebraic expression. Clear? Let us take one more example. That is, in a fruit box, there are some apples and oranges. We don't know the number of apples and number of oranges. Okay? And we are given that number of apples are 6 more than number of oranges. And how can we express this? Yes. First of all, let's assume the number of oranges. Isn't it? Let it be y. Then can you tell me the number of apples? Yes. There are y plus 6 apples. Okay. These are all examples of algebraic expressions. In this way, we can write many examples. Okay. Here, we use some variables and constants to express the algebraic expression. Isn't it? They are combined with the basic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, etc. Isn't it? So, these constants and variables are with constants and variables with operators combined together, we get algebraic expression. So, algebraic expression is a mathematical phrase with the constants, variables and operators. All of you clear? Okay, very good. Now, let us consider an algebraic expression, that is 4y cube plus 3y plus 6. This is an example of algebraic expression. This expression has different parts, isn't it? 4y cube is one part, 3y is another part, 6 is another part. These parts are combined with the operator, isn't it? So each of these parts are called terms. What? Terms. Terms of the expression. Okay. Each of these parts are called the terms. So, all algebraic expressions are made up of terms. Okay. And this each term is a product of a constant and a variable. Here we use the variable y and constant 4. Isn't it? The first term is the product of the variable y and constant 4. This 4 and y cube are called factors. Factors of the term. So, all algebraic expressions are made up of terms. And each of those terms are also made up of constants and variables. And these constants and variables are called factors. All of you clear? Factors. Here, constant factor and variable factor. These constant factors are called numerical factors. Numerical factors. And these variable factors are called algebraic factors. numerical factors and algebraic factors. Clear? Here numerical factors are 4, 3 and 6. The first term is the product of 4 and y cube. Second term is the product of 3 and y. Last term is a constant factor or numerical factor, only 6. Okay. And this constant numerical factors are also known as coefficients. Numerical factors are also known as coefficients. And here each term is a numerical factor along with the variable, isn't it? Here this 4 is called coefficient of y cube, and here 3 is called coefficient of y, okay, and 6 is coefficient, and there is no algebraic factor there, isn't it? So these coefficients, can you tell me then what is the coefficient of this expression minus y? Tell me, children, which is the coefficient of minus y? Yes, minus 1 is the coefficient of y. Okay, in this way we can say coefficients of each term in an algebraic expression. All of you understand? Okay, very good. Now let us consider this algebraic expression. Did you notice any peculiarity in the terms of this expression? Yes, some terms have the same algebraic factors, isn't it? This 3x square and here 4x square both have the same algebraic factor x square, isn't it? And here 4x and 7x both having the algebraic factor x. Such terms are called like terms. What? Like terms. Terms with the same algebraic factors are called like terms. Clear? Here 3x square and 4x square are like terms. And 7y cube and 8y cube are like terms. 2xy and 6xy are like terms. So like terms are terms with the same algebraic factors or same variables. All of you clear? Others are called unlike terms. Unlike terms with a different algebraic factors. Say for example 3x square and 2xy are unlike terms. Okay. And 8y cube and 4x square are unlike terms because they have different algebraic factors, okay, and different variables. So what are like terms and unlike terms? All of you understand? Okay, now let us consider this algebraic expression 4x, 3y, 6z, 2xy plus 3, 6y square minus 5, 2x cube plus 3x minus 5, 6x cube minus 2 plus 5x, and 7z square minus 6z. Consider these algebraic expressions. This expression contains how many terms? Only one term. Did you see any other expression with a one term? Yes. This one is an expression with one term. This is an expression with one term. Isn't it? Such expressions are called monomials. Monomials. algebraic expressions contains only one term, then it is called a monomial. Okay, and consider this expression. How many terms does this expression have? Yes, two terms, isn't it? And what about this one? That also contains two terms. Okay, such expressions are called binomials. Okay, algebraic expressions with the two terms are called binomials. And what about this one and this one? They contains three terms. They are called trinomials. Algebraic expressions with the three terms are called trinomials. Okay, the others are called, that is more than three terms, are called generally polynomials. Okay, in this way we can classify algebraic expressions. All of you clear? Now you got an idea about algebraic expression, isn't it? Okay, thank you. Namaste.